and then thereafter come with issues in both the cities.
What is disability? The World Health Organization describes disability as an umbrella term. It not only restricts activity, it also covers impairments and participation and restricts participation. Government of India, on the other hand, describes disability as a person who is suffering from not less than 40% of any disability as certified by a medical authority. Government of Singapore describes disability as those prospects of securing, retaining places and advancing in education and training institutions, employment, recreation, as equal members of the community are substantially reduced as a result of physical, sensory and intellectual impairments. WHO also says that the world has about 15% of disabled people. That amounts to almost 1 billion people on Earth.
We'll go through a comparative analysis between Singapore and Delhi. Singapore is a southeastern state with a population of about 50 lakhs, with a population of around 2.1%, 2.5% as disabled population. In a survey conducted by the WHO, the World Disability Report confirms that the satisfaction rate in Singapore by the provisions provided by the government is 78% as compared to the 30% satisfaction rate in Delhi.
The public transport in Singapore. Singapore has about 80% of the people travelling by the mass rapid transit, therefore making it the most reliable and the most used form of transport there. The provisions that the government there has given for the mass rapid transport, we can see from the pictures here, as well as the provisions for each of the people having this certain disability. For example, people with wheelchairs have one barrier free entrance, whereas people for blind people have tactile service indicators. For deaf people, there are platforms that indicate. For disabled parking, there's class 1 and class 2. Class 1 parking labels for disabled drivers, whereas class 2 for parking labels for family members of people who are taking care of those disabled people. For blind people, ATMs have audio function, braille plates that allows visually impaired customers to perform banking transactions. For people in wheelchairs, they make it extremely easy for them to commute themselves from.
As we can, in Delhi, we have feeder buses system. Similarly, they have, when a person enters a BRTA system, and from there, having a pedestrian free or having a disabled friendly feeder service, they have another system, which is the WAB, wheelchair accessible buses. Similarly, for the deaf people, they have visual alarms in special hotels in case of emergencies. In case of traffic lights, they have a special card for the disabled people with which, when they use it in a traffic signal, it gives them extra stoppage time for the disabled people. They also have similar events for the disabled people in which for the awareness campaigns for the general public. Also, they have Access Singapore, which is a book which gives a guide to any disabled person which has a list with the places of hotels and buildings that are disabled friendly. Delhi, with a population of around 1.6 crore, has a disabled population of around 2.1%. This also shows a gap. In Singapore, we saw the disabled population as 2.6%, but then the documentation, as ma'am rightly pointed, in Delhi it shows that it's only 2.1%, while we actually know it's more than as compared to the Singapore. The transportation aspects, Delhi Metro, as we all know, is one of the best example, which is disabled friendly.
transport facilities to be given to them. DTC buses are disabled friendly too, as they have low floor and foldable ramps and wheelchair areas.
Now, but when you see, we're covering the issues. When you see the DTC, we have an image that the Delhi buses is not as as disabled friendly as the metro is. But then when a person gets off the
we believe that Delhi lags behind from Singapore in terms of accessibility for specially abled. Thank you.
Thank you.
The jury may now ask the question.
Okay, you are done with your video as well?
Yes, ma'am, we start with the...
Okay, alright.
Do you really call them physically disabled?
Specially able, sir.
Is there anyone who has right answer of this question? Differently able. Specially able. Any other? Physically challenged. I would give you a technically right word, which is internationally accepted. It is persons with disabilities. You have the person, the person with disability is a person first, and then he has disability. It should not be used as an adjective, that disabled person, disabled parking. Is parking disabled? Is person disabled? It is person with disability. He's a person first, and then he has any other disability. Yeah. And my question is very simple, and the question is, what is the right slope for a ramp?
Right slope for a ramp?
For a ramp. What it is, how, what is the right slope, what is the right slope considered in Singapore, and what is right slope considered in India? This would be a little difficult to answer, but what is the right slope in general?
In terms of angle?
Yeah, slope. Yes, slope. Ratio.
Now we'll look into that.
Yeah, it is 1:15 in India, and it is 1:20 in Singapore. Okay. And that makes a lot of difference. You know, if you have 1:10 ramp, not a single person, those who use wheelchair or those who have any lower limb impairment,
yeah,
would be able to use that ramp. You know, many a times in Delhi, all those bus stops have very difficult ramp. It is difficult for all people, those who are wheelchair users or those who have any, and in fact it is difficult to use for even able-bodied person, you know. It is such, there are such steep ramp. So one should be very careful when you are assessing any facility for mobility impairment. Right? It can be just a kind of a eye wash instead of a real facility.
In a starting video, we had that example. Even though the place has a ramp walk, but then five people are pulling up that wheelchair and taking him upstairs. That's because of the slope angle. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And one more thing, when we talk about wheelchair users, there are only, I would say, 5 to 6% of the people, those who have impairments, those who use wheelchair. Rest of them have vision impairment, hearing impairment, those who have any kind of lower limb impairment, for whom handrail is more important than a ramp. So we have to be very careful when we are talking about accessibility, because we are not just designing for wheelchair. Okay, and even if we are doing it for wheelchair, then even small little things like ramps don't make a lot of difference.
Thank you.